next song we will be writing for you this evening is Everybody Needs a Friend. This piece is from a collection of five different pieces called We Need the Power. This collection was by Robert Thomason.
The next two performances will be sung by the two girls in the 7th grade choir that received superior ratings at the annual solo and ensemble competition.
Lavender, lavender, lavender shall turn you. storyteller, and she's telling the story of this girl who's pretty much lost the love of her life. So.
And dads and friends, how many of you, I don't know how to ask this question, how many of you don't understand what solo and ensemble competition is? Raise your hand. You've heard of that or not? Okay. Very quickly, what it is, every year, the middle school, junior high, and the high schools have an area, it's not really a competition where we have winners and losers. At this age, we don't really need that. And what it is, we bring in judges from outside of the district. We have a 5-county district. District 3 is one of the largest in the state. They bring in people from outside of the area. Your student, the judges are paid, so there is a student fee. And we have there's certain kinds of music. I call it generic music, meaning that the kids haven't heard a major artist sing it. So they're not impersonating anybody or imitating, they're just them. So they go, and there is a standard of excellence. Are they on pitch? Do they have the right notes? Are they singing with louds and softs? Are they able to tell a story while they sing? And the judge will then give them a rating as superior, like an A, B, C, D. And we had about 20 students that participated. We had all ones, twos, and threes. And then we also have another category. If the student has worked and they're still feeling really nervous about what they're doing, they can go just for comments only, and they don't have to worry about a rating. And so we had, I think, at least 4 or 5 that also went. So tonight we have 4 of the students. There'll be 2 eighth graders later on. Some chose not to. They said, we don't like that big a crowd. We really don't want to do that yet. But every year we have this, and the number of people that we have, I'm very proud of, that go on into the churches, into the colleges, into different places as soloists. And this is when we start.
Of a relationship the girl had with this guy, but when he wanted her back, she turned him down. The next song we will be singing is called Go Away From My Window by John Jacob Nines.
Next song we'll be singing for you is Let Us Sing by Sally Kay Albrecht.
The first song of tonight is a song by John Parker entitled Heivu Mandari, which in Swahili means Come Now, Dance. Swahili is an African language and the language we'll be singing this song in. To better assist your comprehension of this song, I will make a few translations. Heivu Unga Mandari means Come Now, Join the Dance. Maha Thihu Luki means Rhythm of Our Beat. Yazi Ini Wimbadai translates to fill your heart with singing. Tamu Wardi Pita translates to sweet rose dies. And Watutu Kulika translates to children listen. I hope you enjoy this wonderful piece of Swahili music.
Thank you. Out Here on My Own is a three-part mixed piece by Michael Gore. The lyrics by Leslie Gore speak of a road that everyone has traveled, a story of hardships and ridicule that must be endured to find out who and what you really are inside, not what others perceive you as.
Molly, and she's singing Wayfaring Stranger. The song that I'm going to sing is about a man that's close to death, and he can't wait to get to heaven and meet his family and meet his Savior.
Stay.
The next soloist that will be singing tonight is Rachel Hurtz singing Cod Romeo Ben.
My song is Cod Romeo Ben, and it's in Italian, so you don't understand it, but it's a deep love song, and it's translated to English as Thou All My Bliss, and it's saying, like, when you're far from me, my heart is torn, and it's just a really deep love song.
Thank you.
The choir's next selection is a three-part mix featuring only the girls. This song compares the recovery of heartbreak to crossing a wide river and picking the right flower. It also focuses on how sweet true love really is. The title is The Water is Wide, and it was arranged by Laura Fornell.
Good evening. Our next piece we'll be performing is called Ocho Cor. It's a folk song. A folk song is a song passed on by being taught, by performance, and hearing throughout the generations. It is music by which people of a nation or ethnic group use to identify themselves. The composers are unknown. It is a three-part mix song arranged by Yearling Woods. We hope you enjoy.
Stories of every.
combined choir. The first one is one called Clouds. We've been talking about what songs mean, whether what you think of what our country is doing, whether you are positive about the war, or whether you're somewhere in between, or whether you're against, that's a part of being Americans. But this writer did not write this with the Iraq War in mind, but he had definitely a war in mind, rather she. And it's talking about how the clouds must look down on us as human beings and cry at some of the things that we do. The second piece is a spiritual called Jump Down that I thought was meant to be funny. And I accidentally, once in a while, I do something intelligent, and this one was accidental. I saw a special on slavery, and it got my attention because we do a lot of spirituals. And it was talking about some of the words from this song. The words are jump down, turn around, and I thought, okay, the slaves have had, they're performing a game. Pick a bale of cotton. Jump down, turn around, pick a bale a day. And we've been having an awfully good time with this. And I went in and I told the students what I had learned. The slaves would start at sunrise, and they were picking cotton. I've never picked cotton, maybe some of you have. They say that when you start, you get a rash, that your body has to get used to it. And they would pick until sundown, or sometimes later. And here was the catch. They had to pick. A bale of cotton was 250 pounds. Think of that small little cotton thing that you're picking. And you had to pick 250 pounds, or you were beaten. That's if you had a bad slave owner. Now, the slaves had turned that into this jump-down turnaround. They knew that if they didn't get the 250 pounds, they were going to be beaten. But that was okay because they were going to have a good time in the meantime. So first of all, clouds, and then jump down, turn around, and if we do it right, you'll see what I'm talking about. If we don't, you'll see it too.
Down like teardrops. Now, you all get to learn. It's bright and loud. I'm here. Folks, thank you. Good night.